In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Angle Bisectors. Now our instructions are to construct the bisector of each angle, and that's for numbers 1 and 2. Now, in order to construct an angle bisector, we're going to take our compass, place one point on the vertex of the angle, then we're going to make an arc along that angle. Now where that arc intersects each of the segments, we're going to place our compass and make a mark to the inside of that angle. Keeping our compass the same measure, we're going to move it to the other intersection and then make another mark inside of that angle. Where those marks intersect, that point will lie on the angle bisector. So now we'll just draw a line from the vertex through that intersection point. And that is the angle bisector. Let's repeat that in number 2. So starting with our compass, we'll make an arc, and as opposed to drawing it the entire way, you could just make one mark from the vertex and then a mark from the vertex intersecting that other segment that helps form that angle. Now from each of the segments, we're going to draw a mark and see where those intersect. That point of intersection will now be connected to the vertex to form our angle bisector. Let's move on to number 3. For 3 and 4, it says for each triangle, construct the angle bisector of angle A. So we're still constructing the angle bisector, this time it's just within a triangle, but the steps are the same. So the segments that make up A, we're going to use our compass to find intersection marks that are the same distance from that vertex. From those intersection points, we're going to then draw another mark within that angle from each place or point where the arc intersected the segments that made that angle. And since we went the same distance away from each of those arcs, we will now be able to draw a line that intersects vertex A and goes through that intersection in order to form our angle bisector. So there's our angle bisector in number 3. Now note that an angle bisector divides an angle directly in half. So this angle is congruent to this angle. In number 4, here is our vertex A. So we'll start by making marks on each of the segments that help create that angle. So the segment here and the segment there, making sure those marks are the same distance from A. Now, adjusting our compass, we'll put a mark inside of the angle from one intersection point and then inside of the angle from that other intersection point. Where those two marks meet, that will be a point on that angle bisector. So from vertex A through that intersection point will be our angle bisector. Let's move on to the second page. On this page, we're going to be locating the in-center of each triangle. The in-center is the point of intersection of the angle bisectors within a triangle. So if we were to label this triangle A, B, C, there's an angle bisector associated with each vertex, A, B, and C. However, we only need 2 to find the intersection. So we'll start by finding the angle bisector of point A. So making a mark on segment AB, and a mark on segment AC that's the same distance from that vertex A. Well then, from each of those intersection points, make a mark to find that intersection. Now we can draw a line from vertex A through where those previous arcs met. That is the angle bisector of A. Now let's find the angle bisector of B. For the angle bisector of B, we'll make a mark on line AB and a mark on line BC. From each of those intersections, we'll draw a mark and another mark to see where those intersect. Now from that intersection, we'll connect it to vertex B in order to form the angle bisector of B, and that point is the end center. where those two angle bisectors intersect. That is known as the end center. Let's move on to number 6. Number 6, I'll label this triangle X, Y, Z. So let's find the angle bisector of Z and Y. For the angle bisector of Z, we're going to put two marks, or simply draw an arc, from side YZ and YX. The points where that arc intersects the segments that form angle Z are the same distance from vertex Z. So from there, we'll draw two marks, and that intersection point will fall on the angle bisector. So from vertex Z through that intersection will be the angle bisector of Z. Now for the angle bisector of Y, placing our point of our compass on vertex Y, drawing an arc, and then from the intersection points that arc forms, we will create another point of intersection that will fall on the angle bisector of Y. And the point at which those angle bisectors intersect is known as the end center. Let's move on to our next set of directions. For the last two problems on this page, number 7 and 8, it says for each triangle, construct all three angle bisectors to show that they are concurrent. Now, before I jump into this, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, concurrent means that all lines will intersect at the same point. So each of those angle bisectors will intersect at that end center, which will be the point of concurrency. So I'll label this triangle A, B, C. Let's first find the angle bisector of A. Placing our compass on A, we'll make an arc, and then from that point drawing within that angle, I'll find an intersection. And that point of intersection will help me form my angle bisector of A. Now for B, again, I'll make my arc, or two marks on each of the segments that help form that angle. And from the intersection of the arc and those segments, I'll be able to find another point that will be on my angle bisector. Now connecting vertex B to that intersection point, there is my other angle bisector. Now lastly, I'll find the angle bisector of C. Now that I've drawn my angle bisector of C, you can see that all three angle bisectors do indeed intersect at the same point, therefore they are concurrent. Let's move on to the last problem, number 8. In number 8, I'll have triangle QRS. So first we'll find the angle bisector of Q. So making my arc from vertex Q, so that I have two points that are same distance from Q that fall on the segments that create that angle, I'll then find the intersection of those two arcs in order to form my angle bisector of Q. Now I'll form my angle bisector of S. So you can see here is my intersection point, and I will connect that with vertex S. And lastly, my angle bisector of angle R. Making marks from those intersection points, I'll find my point that lies on that angle bisector and can therefore connect that with vertex R to form the angle bisector. And you can see that all three lines intersect and are therefore concurrent. So the end center is the intersection of angle bisectors, and that point is concurrent. And with that, we wrap up this worksheet. If you didn't do so before numbers 7 and 8, remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel.